Hello everyone, LuigiFan32 here. I really didn't want to do this serious conversation, but I need to get all the stuff from my chest that I've been hiding. I don't know how long this video is gonna be, so we'll see. I didn't say everything about it in my mental health video a while back, but there are a lot of reasons I'm not making much Mario 64 content anymore. The community has had a lot of drama the past few years. Me, along with plenty of other Mario 64 YouTubers out there, have been attacked, bullied, disrespected, or other stuff. For safety purposes, I'm not gonna address any names in this video. Out of respect, I'm not here to make it worse than it already is. Nobody should come and attack them. My situation, it all started back in 2014. I had a really rough time in high school. Every day I went through shitty moods. I got bullied, made fun of, got laughed at. I didn't fit in anywhere. Man. Of course, at the time I went through puberty, obviously it's one of the hardest times in your life. Not many people gave me respect. I then discovered SMG4's channel, which was one of the channels at the time that really pulled me through those hard times at high school. High school, am I right? I mean, I'm not saying I was entirely innocent in this. When I first made this account all the way back in 2013, I started trolling people, but this was to hide my own pain, so I shared my pain with others that way. I mean, I love being a jerk online, but I realized 4 years later that this wasn't the kind of person I wanted to be. I was still trying to find myself, I still am, like what person I wanted to become. It wasn't until 2017 that I slowly started healing, and I realized I slowly became the bully myself. I also wasn't respectful and nice myself when I had to deal with high school. To some of you, I may have come over as rather rude or maybe an asshole, which I'm really not, trust me. I just sometimes don't think what I say. I'm probably not the only one behaving like this. So, I'm sorry if somebody felt offended if I was saying something. I didn't mean it in a bad way. My emotions took the better of me. Which is why I took a 3-year long break from this channel. I was still learning and evolving, making Mario 64 content. SMG4 used to be my inspiration. I met plenty of other people within the Super Mario 64 community, but then a year passed and then decided to revive my channel, or at least I tried to, because after that everything went downhill. At the time I'm making this video, I'm an adult. It doesn't matter what age I am, because I'm not comfortable with actually sharing more personal information. You may notice my channel started dying around 2015 and didn't upload again until 2017, but I revived my channel successfully in 2019, where I grew out of this phase of anxiety and depression and other personal stuff. I needed time to heal myself, obviously. I was all gone, you know. From the situations I went through. So a lot has happened from 2015 up until 2018. So there was obviously the whole Storm and Tree fiasco, which I'm not gonna go into detail. I was a victim of his behavior too. Watch Matthew Guy Force video if you want more info on this. Pause the video if you need to listen to what he has to say. and then return back to this video. So in this example, I'm referring to the three people as A, B, and C. Me and person, me and person A had been friends for a while. I trusted him. We occasionally talked, but one day during 2018, there was this situation that happened to me, and person B, who was well known at the time but not for her content, she was a nice person. At least that's what I thought about her, and also about person A. Months passed by, I didn't saw her for a while, and person A either. Me and her occasionally had differences, and we got into plenty of arguments, so I gave up on her and blocked her. Again, months passed by. I then talked to person A, who at the time was also friends with person B. But eventually we all grew apart. Person A blocked B too. After a while, I decided to give person A another chance. Because everyone deserves another chance, right? At the time, I didn't know better. I began talking to person A again. But something was rather off about him. He was behaving totally different. And acted like he didn't want anything to do with me anymore. He then called me out for being a hypocrite. Which I guess is about the situation of me giving person B another chance. But at this day I really don't know what the reason was. So yeah, I asked how am I a hypocrite in Discord. He didn't respond for a while. All he did was yell to me, "I don't want to be around you anymore. I don't want to have to do anything with you anymore." I kept asking him what I did wrong, but I never got an answer. And we also ended up blocking each other eventually. So I was really upset. I started giving up in the Mario 64 community. And just when I thought things would be better again, it became even worse. I checked social media daily. It was weekly that I saw an argument between two Super Mario 64 YouTubers. I could relate so much to it, but I didn't want to help. Neither did I want to go step in or get myself involved. So I stayed at the sidelines. I was hoping to make a fresh start once a lot of the drama settled down. Then, let me take a quick break here. Then there was person C. He made a rant video about me and started a trend called Cancel Waluigi Fan. I was still really depressed at that point. He made fun of me feeling bad, saying stuff like, "You kinda deserve it, dude. You're really an asshole. You deserve everything that's coming to you." I was hurt even more, of course. At the time, I never heard of person C, and he tried exposing me for literally no reason. It was all fake news. Yes, I may come over as rude sometimes, but it isn't intentional. I'm a really respectful person, and I really think mental health is important. If you call me out for stuff like this, it's because you don't know me personally. Again, excuse me. I had a lot of different emotions that had gotten the better of me. I became aggressive to some people that didn't deserve it. I lost hope in the whole community. I apologized to people who I accidentally offended a long time ago. Man, I can barely talk. I couldn't act as myself anymore. Because obviously, people pulled me out of my own boundaries. So the cancel Waluigi fan thing became a trend around YouTube. So I was afraid of showing myself on YouTube again under the name Waluigi Fan 32. At the time I also had ideas of changing my username so nobody would recognize me. So person A, B and C are the reasons I now had even more trust issues, and my self-esteem was just completely gone at this point. People suddenly started to turn against me for the video that person C made about me. Then continued to hound me for a long time, but by the time he privated the video, it was already too late. It was too late to take a fresh start. I started to question myself, started to think I was a bad person, but I eventually grew out of this phase and realized it's just how life goes. Sometimes it goes your way, sometimes it doesn't. Just remember this. It doesn't matter what nationality you have. It doesn't matter if you're gay, straight, asexual. It doesn't matter if you have autism, ADHD, Tourette's. Maybe you're a furry or have other interests. You are free to express yourself, and it doesn't matter if other people think it's weird. Changing who you are only gets you in situations you don't want. I'm scared about the future, but I'm also worried. My grandfather has been fighting against cancer for around 10 years. I have a close connection with him. I don't want to lose anyone around me, and I hate change. Everything changes so quickly, but in the end we are all here. We will fight together until the end. Now I'd like to give some shoutouts to some of my online friends who have been supporting me. It's gonna be a long list. Epic Luigi Kids, Dr. K / Dark Lucario, Koji Chan, Adrian the Seedling Umbreon, Dylan Greeny Goldie Ray and Rainbow Yoshi, Energy, Green Zoroark, Luke the Lucario, Big Yellow Buddy, Warren, Springstar, Zenith, Dudboy, Mario Gaming 42, Protoken / Kenneth, Holo, Spyro the Dragon 2021, Nicholas Kozer, and lots of others I didn't mention. I just kindly ask you all to talk to the person or get to know the person before jumping immediately to conclusions. Rumors spread really fast. That doesn't necessarily mean that they're all true. Yes, people make mistakes, not all people get along. I'm not trying to describe myself as a victim, but I was there, on the sideline, watching how Super Mario 64 YouTubers took each other down, mostly mentally. I really don't care about Starman 3, for example, but there are some people that don't deserve all the hate. Starting now, I need to use names because I really want to address this. I've seen Ahmed TR38 getting attacked. There was a fight between Luigi Pie and Ahmed, which I'm not gonna talk about. I'm neutral on this. I didn't know Luigi Pie myself and had a good connection with Ahmed. Honestly, Luigi Pie is a good YouTuber and he seems really nice. Obviously my first impression, but so is Ahmed, he's also nice. Then other YouTubers got attacked. Mickey Mario 64, who is now making fun Pokemon content and kinda moved away from Mario 64, which honestly I fully support him on this decision. So shout out to Mickey and Luigi Pie. But also Mario Sparky, G of Crazy, I don't know how to pronounce his name properly, so Jeff Crazy. But also Pinkish Glitchy Mario 5, and there are a lot of other people probably that I'm not mentioning in this video. They all just got hated on. I saw it with my own eyes. It was horrible to see. I mean, come on people. We are a community for a reason. To come together, we have similar interests. We must support each other and not break each other down. Jeez. Some people are more sensitive than others, be aware of that. It's perfectly fine to point out a mistake, but do it in a respectful manner. That's all I have to say about it. I'm still kind of trying to push myself making Mario 64 videos, because I don't want to let my early subscribers down. but the motivation is never really there anymore. Our job as a community is also to help others, not necessarily Mario 64, but we need to make the community fun for everyone to join. Sure, it may take some time, but the point of a community is to get along. You have to feel comfortable being a part of it. We are in an awful pandemic right now that won't go away anytime soon. Wear a mask, but also don't wear a mask and be yourself. Mental health is also very important to me. I used to act differently from the person I was inside. I was scared of being myself, scared of people taking advantage of me if I was too nice. I was a victim of bullying. Maybe you were too. We need to connect with each other now more than ever. It's okay to be sad, depressed or angry. We are going through tough times. Know that whatever you're feeling, anxiety, stress or anything else, you are never alone. Let us all strive together to make the Super Mario 64 community a relaxing place by treating each other with respect and no neglect. Listen to each other. Talk it out whenever there's a fight. There's no wrong or right. Show everybody the light. Thank you very much. Let's try to stay positive. We must pull each other forward, no matter what mood you're in. I hope you have a great day. So in the end, the moral of the story is probably don't judge what you can't understand. Get to know people before attacking them. You may get along better with someone than you expect at first. Well, thank you guys for making it till the end of the video. Stay safe everyone, and talk to others when you're feeling down. I'm also here for you. And yeah, Waluigi fan out.